This is Gabriel Chana, author of Silver Skies. Matthew McConaughey got cast as the character Dor Ben Habakkuk, who's the lead from my novel Silver Skies. This book did go to film. It was a Steven Spielberg production. It's only shown at independent film festivals. The Jesuits have kept it from the mainstream public, in spite of the fact that Silver Skies is a brilliant book. And Matthew McConaughey won his first Oscar for his performance as Dor Ben Habakkuk. I'll be reading from the book. We are in Dor Ben Habakkuk's point of view. 2 days later, he returned to Houston. His attorney, Mr. Markowitz, was booked, and the soonest he could see him was in 2 weeks. It would be worth it. Mr. Markowitz was the best. He remembered when he visited him many years ago with Brianna. Then Dor was in a wheelchair, and Brianna was wonderful. The memory brought a pang to his heart. He had to get her back. The appointment finally came. He arrived at the law firm of Markowitz and Cohen and seated himself before Stuart Markowitz. "How can I help you?" Mr. Markowitz said. "I've been slandered by the press, which I can take, but it's cost me the love of my life. She believes I'm a womanizer now, or that I play games with her, and won't have anything to do with me. So what can I do for you?" "I want to sue the press for slander." Mr. Markowitz straightened himself in his chair. A lawsuit would do you more harm than good." "Can I demand they put a correction in the papers and magazines?" Mr. Markowitz reached into a drawer. "I don't recommend a lawsuit. You may want to write them and use this wording when you write them." He handed Dor a paper. "It's worked for many of my clients." "Why not a lawsuit?" "The Catholic Church is behind the slander, and they have incredible power in the judicial system." "How did the Catholic Church get in this?" "They're behind the New World Order." Dor stared at a wall and couldn't bring his mind back to earth. "If you brought this to court, the Roman Catholic Church would appoint a judge who'd stop me from giving the jury the facts they'd need to make a fair judgment." "They have that much power?" "The Catholic Church has repeated what they did in Nazi Germany. They've appointed their own government agents and judges." He stared at Stuart Markowitz in astonishment. Suddenly, the office seemed cold and he shivered. His heart became lead. "If we bring this to court as defamation, the defense lawyer could tell the jury anything he wants, but the judge would hinder my presentation and sway the verdict against us." Dor bowed his head. "It's monstrous." "Do you want to keep Brianna?" "Of course." His jaw clenched. "She's quite intelligent. That should help you. Because if you lost this case, they could make you look worse. Because they also control the press, and would use the press to defame you further. The shame he could take, but to lose her. Let the whole world think him a womanizer if that's what he needed to win her back." "You're right. I better not sue the press." Mr. Markowitz came to him and embraced him. "Many times I've thought of quitting my legal practice." "Don't give up on Brianna. She's special." The next morning, the headlines to the paper said, "All guns banned except single-shot rifles and pistols." That night, he dreamed that tanks and flamethrowers bombarded and torched his synagogue. The violators, those that refused to submit to the regime, suffered defeat as jets flew overhead and bombed their homes. People tried to protect their property. The repeated volley of machine gun fire overwhelmed the violators' futile blasts from single-shot rifles and pistols. Communism taught the land belonged to the government, but the people revolted. Projectile-firing guns and mounted missile launchers whizzed toward the violators, while their frustrated rifles and pistols echoed back screams and bloodshed. The crime. They didn't want a totalitarian government ruling them and stealing their property. Dor woke up more determined than ever to finish his book. The next day he put finishing touches on it. It had sat around, and he'd almost forgotten about it in his attempts to reclaim Brianna. but the world around him was crumbling, and he had to do something. The answer, finish his book. If only Brianna was here. He could show her his book and tell her about his dreams to defeat this terror. She'd understand. She'd know what to say. She'd make him feel strong enough to face his fears. But she left him. He wrote a letter to the Houston paper asking them to put a correction in the paper about the women in the photographs with him, that they'd explain these were his co-workers, not his romantic interests. They published his letter, and he received a short letter from the newspaper. We will investigate your concerns, but can find no evidence of fraudulent journalism. The international press wrote the stories, and you should direct your complaints to them. Dora called France in Seattle. Has Brianna changed her mind towards me now that I sent her a copy of my published letter? France was quiet. What copy? We never got it. Paul is filling Brianna's mind with poison. What's she telling her? Paula believes everything the press and magazines say about you and recommends Brianna stay away from you. Does Brianna agree with her? She's dated a man quite frequently. Another handsome doctor. The doctor seemed taken with her. Yeah, I just read you a portion from my novel Silver Skies, which was made into a Steven Spielberg movie called Silver Skies, starring Matthew McConaughey as the lead, Dor Ben Habakkuk. I'm not sure who played the lead, Brianna Wilhelm. The book and movie Silver Skies was inspired by my relationship with my long distance phone relationship with Brent Spiner in the 1990s. And what I did was I created a Texas rabbi who lived in Houston, Texas, because Brent's Jewish and he's a Texan and he's from Houston. And this rabbi was born and raised in Brent Spiner's hometown, which is Meyerland or Bel Air, Texas. Any of you who've read my book, Silver Skies, you realize that's how I, you know, it was really strange. Out of 120 possible duty stations, Jesus Christ moved my family to the Houston, Texas area. And I saw that as a sign from God that he approved of my relationship with Brent Spiner, and it was a sign from God. Let me tell you how I found out about Matthew McConaughey. I had never heard of Matthew McConaughey until November 2005. I was working as a cashier at Walmart. I had just finished my book, Silver Skies. I kind of sat on it and didn't write the ending for like 7 or 8 years. Because when I originally wrote it, it was just like a labor of love, just to try to write a story about the inspiring love that I had between myself and Brent Spiner. So that's why it's a love story. And I finally finished it. And I was having brain-to-brain conversation with Vladimir Putin, who was my main brain-to-brain lover in 2005. And I looked at the People magazine cover, and I saw a man on the cover whose name was Matthew McConaughey, voted Sexiest Man Alive. And the first thing that came to my mind was, wow, that guy looks just like the Dor Ben Habakkuk, the expression and everything. He looks just like Dor Ben Habakkuk from my novel Silver Skies. And Vladimir Putin said, hey, Gail, Matthew McConaughey wants to talk to you brain to brain. We've hooked him up. Do you want to talk to him? I said, oh, sure. So Matthew says, hey, I'm glad you noticed me. Well, what I did is I'm glad you noticed me. I said, so you got cast as Dor Ben Habakkuk for Silver Skies? And Matthew said, yeah, yeah. He says, you know what? I really admire you as a writer, Gail. He says, I thought your novel was great. And he said, I got to admit, I fell in love with you after I read your book. And I thought, oh, Matthew. I said, I'm so honored. And he said, yeah. I said, well, you know what? I kind of suspected that they might have cast you as Dor Ben Habakkuk because you're a Texan. And my lead character is a Texan. And you look like you could play a Jewish role. And I said, the only thing is my rabbi got a beat up face, you know, in the film. And he's not supposed to be super duper handsome. And
And then Matthew said, well, they did a little bit of makeup work on my face, so in the movie I don't look quite, like I did on the cover of People magazine, Sexiest Man Alive and all that. And then I can't remember everything that me and Matthew talked about brain to brain back then. It's been a while. But I remember he was very humble, very down to earth, and very much of a gentleman. And I was very impressed with him. And I said, well, I said, I wish I could see the movie they're making from my book. I'm really honored that they've cast you as the lead. You seem like you'd be great. I said, you just look like the part. And he said, well, thank you, Gail. He said, I really, he said, this has been, he said, of all the roles I've played, this one has really meant the most to me. And he said, it's just, it's a real, he said, it's a real honor to play the role of Dor from your book. And he said, congratulations on your Nobel Prize. I said, oh, shucks, Matthew. I said, I didn't win a Nobel Prize. He says, yeah, in a secret ceremony, he said, you did. And he said, I'm really honored to play Dor Ben Habakkuk. I said, well, I'll tell you're a Texan, Matthew, so I can see why Steven Spielberg. I said, how did you get the part? He said, well, they auditioned a bunch of actors, and Spielberg just loved me in this role. He said I was perfect. And I said, well, how long will it be till the movie's done? He says, well, we're in the middle of filming, and he said it should be out within a month or so. He said, we actually started filming on the book before you finished the book, because we had like 98% of your book. And I just he told me, he said, one thing that really impressed me about your writing was he said your love scenes have such depth and depth of feeling, and they're so layered. He said it's been a real challenge to portray those in a manner that honors your book, but he said it's an honor. He said I'm truly honored to have gotten this role, and he said, like I said, Gail, I fell in love with you. I said, but Matthew, don't you have a girlfriend named Penelope Cruz? He said, oh, yeah. He said, Penelope understands that since you came into my life, that there's no other woman that I would want right now. I said, Matthew, I have Vladimir Putin right now, and he's number one on my marriage list, and I really am not going to encourage you to, think of me in any romantic fashion. He said, yeah, I know that, Gail. Vladimir warned me about this about you, but I'm just so impressed with you, and I think you're really hot. He says, I think you should be sexiest woman alive. I said, oh, shucks, Matthew. I said, no. And so, anyways, that's basically the gist of it. And then we just kind of lost contact with each other for a while. And that is until Vladimir Putin had a near fatal heart attack. And then Vladimir talked to me. He said, Gail, is it okay if I allow Matthew to take my place for a month while I recuperate? I said, oh, no, I can't do this to you, Vladimir. That would be unfaithfulness. And he said, well, it'll just make me not worry about you. He said, because you're such a passionate woman, I just want to make sure your needs are met. So I reluctantly agreed. And Matthew was a thrilling lover for a month, brain to brain, all kind of like fantasy loving. So it wasn't real sex, but that's how me and Matthew got started. And about 4 or 5 months later, the Jesuits attacked Matthew McConaughey with Camilla Alves. And I knew it wasn't true, because the way he made love to me was so sensitive, tender, such a gentleman, Matthew, and so full of depth and commitment. It just, I know, because of the brain-to-brain communications I've had with Matthew, I can assure you, the real Matthew McConaughey is nothing like the Jesuit Matthew McConaughey clone out there. When you, probably the best picture of Matthew McConaughey is the picture of him on the People magazine cover for 2005, when he was voted Sexiest Man Alive. When you look at that face, you see Matthew McConaughey, manly, a Texan, deep, and very macho, like the lead character in my novel, Silver Skies. They picked